Today I'm going to be making a custom plywood with different shades of colors because I want to CNC a landscape out of it. And while I do that, I'll show you how I go about it and some tips and tricks to avoid mistakes along the way. Hi everyone, welcome to Qube. My name is David and today we're going to be making plywood. Not just your regular plywood out of the DIY store, but we're gonna go extra fancy and we're gonna be making rainbow wood, which is basically plywood made out of colored veneers, and I'll show you just how we do that. Along the way I'll show you some tips and tricks about grain direction and glue and stuff like that, and in the end I'll show you some possibilities on what you can do when you make your own plywood. Let's go! Before we start gluing up and cutting everything to size, maybe it's a good time to tell you a little more about plywood and what makes plywood plywood. But why don't you come a little closer, I'll show you. Plywood is always made out of different plies, as the word implies. And they're usually glued up in uneven numbers, 3, 5, 7, 11, 15 in my case. And what we're going to be doing is gluing these up, and we're going to be shifting the grain direction in the lengthwise and in the widthwise. Usually they're made out of the same thicknesses of material, but this doesn't have to be the case. In fact, if you're making a tri-ply, you can go as thick as a half centimeter or something like that and have a really strong and consistent bond. And this way your plywood is going to be really strong, especially when you're working with really nice woods like oak and stuff like that. But it can be really thin as well. As you see here, this is a cheap plywood. The outer layer isn't even a millimeter thick. So there's actually 7 plies here, but you can barely see the outer ply. It's really thin. Once you start sanding this, there isn't going to be much left. And that's why we're making our own plywood. We want it to be strong, we want it to be stable, we want to determine the thicknesses of each layer, and sometimes we even want a special look, like for instance with this rainbow wood, or if you want to make something really special and you want the outer parts to be something custom like bamboo or the bird's eye or palm or whatever. In fact, the outer layer can be whatever you want. The inner layers in fact don't really matter, except for the appearance on the top and sides, but usually we're going to be hiding those anyway. So today I'm going to be making custom plywood with different shades of colors because I want to CNC a landscape out of it. And while I do that, I'll show you how I go about it and some tips and tricks to avoid mistakes along the way. So for the landscape, I'm going to be using some different colors. I'm going to be working from top to bottom, and first layers I want to look like the earth, so greens and stuff like that. Then as we go deeper down below, so third or fourth layer, I want to be going into the browns and black. And then at the bottom, I want to be working with blues and dark blues, just so I can put some kind of river in it. But we'll see how it goes. We'll quickly go through these and see what we can come up with. There, I think these will be it. The idea is to have it layered like you would cut a slice of the middle of the earth. So I think I'm going to be starting with light green and green. And then I think we're going to be switching it up between the river colors and the earth colors, the browns and the blacks. This is going to be our last layer. But as you can see, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 8, so I'm gonna have to skip one just so we get an uneven number, and then we'll start gluing. As far as glue goes, you have different options. DIY, the normal wood glue would be just fine. if you think it will be in humid environments, you're going to be needing water resistant glue. If you want it to be ultra strong and ultra stable, well, then you can go for epoxy as well. If you want to go all in with the glue and be really sure about the adhesion and the properties and things like that, you're going to be looking for urea resin glue. It's basically what they use in professional plywood, so if you can get your hands on that, go ahead, give it a try. But as far as my experience goes, I've had great results with tie bond 2 and 3, or a regular wood glue will be just fine. I didn't have any hiccups with those. I have one secret ingredient though, and that's salt. Just your regular normal salt, and that prevents everything from slipping while you press it or clamp it down. Great tip, really works. Just go run in the kitchen, grab yourself a little bit of salt. It will work just great. As far as clamping goes, you have again a lot of options depending on your workshop or what you have access to. A vacuum pump works really great. You just put everything inside the bag, you suck the air out of it in between two pieces of wood that you know are extremely flat or completely flat. Other way is just take two boards, birch plywood for example, and you just laminate everything in between and you squeeze the hell out of it with your normal clamps. Or you can make a little jig to help you with that. You make a couple of these, which is basically two by fours or four by fours, and then you can clamp everything in between just like that. And then there's another way, and that's the way we're going to be using today. And that's basically a press that uses bottle jacks. And I'll show you that later. That's my go-to method here in the shop. Really easy, really handy. And I've had some really good results with this. But enough of the theory. Let's start gluing and clamping. Let's go. Before I tell you something more about how we're going to glue this and press this all together, I'm just gonna make sure all these plies are orientated in the right way, and then we'll talk gluing and clamping. All right, let's start gluing this landscape up. Normally, when I'm gluing up big things, I like to use this guy. It's basically a bucket where I can pour glue in. And then you have like a foam roller. It's really handy to apply a lot of glue really fast when you're working, for example, with rainbow wood where you have 15 plies. It's a do or bust when you have to apply two coats of glue on each ply. But for today, I'm just gonna be using a regular tray and this guy. Let's go. There we go, that's ready for clamping. We're gonna put this in between two torsion boxes and we'll apply some pressure with the bottle jack. There we go. We'll leave that in there for at least 24 hours and then we'll continue shaping it. Now, why would you want to make plywood for yourself? Well, for me, it all started with this guy, the rainbow wood. And I like to make stuff with this in all kinds of shapes, like this stool leg. If I didn't make it myself, I wouldn't be able to get these cool colors, but I wouldn't be able to get these nicely shaped forms as well. Another reason is pure aesthetics. For example, this guy is basically
plywood as well, but really thin. It's only three layers, and it gives me the opportunity to play even more with the colors than I would in this shape. It could be for aesthetic reasons as well. For example, with this Sobrano or this Purple Heart. This way you don't have to buy a whole piece of Purple Heart, but you can just laminate your pieces together and make the top and bottom side in Purple Heart. It looks really great and it's really strong as well. Talking about strength, that's another option. If you need, for example, a piece of oak, but you need it to be really strong and really stable, then you can laminate three pieces of oak together and it will make for a very strong and stable piece of oak. And let's be real, not all the plywoods look really great. So if you can choose whatever plies you're gonna be using, well, then you're gonna be getting the look you're after.
Let's get this out of the clamp and I'll show you what we've got.
And there we have it. One custom made plywood with, I think, seven layers. How much was it again? Nine layers of pretty colors. Next step for me at least is to try and make a landscape out of this one.
But wait, there is more. I was going to finish the video right here, just showing you how I made the custom plywood and show you some tips and tricks. But to be honest, I was just too curious to see how it turned out. So I put the CNC, my snap maker, to work and I finished this one right here. It took about 15 hours to cut all of this. I really should learn a little bit more about tool pot configurations so I can get a more efficient cut, but it turned out really great. This is straight from the CNC, so I didn't have a chance to finish it, but this will look amazing. I just wanted to share with you guys how it turned out, and I'll quickly go over how I did it, so you can give it a shot for yourself. Let's go. I'm not gonna go over the entire process of how I made the drawing in Fusion 360. I'm pretty sure there are plenty of videos about that. Maybe I can show you that another time as well. But basically what I did was I've marked all the colors I've chosen for the custom plywood. And I determined the thickness of each layer. And this way I knew, for example, light brown, I want the streets on my map to be light brown. So I knew I had to go to about 5.25 millimeters deep to be sure I'd be in between the minimum and the maximum depth. So I was sure all my streets were light brown. Light green, for example. I live in a quite green neighborhood, so everything which basically is buildings and civilization, as you could say, I wanted everything in that range to be light green. Everything which is forests and really the green areas, I wanted darker green. So that's basically the first layer you see when you look at the model. And as we continue, there are different colors I've chosen for the map. And for example, all the blues, well, you see a river going through it, and that's why I chose different colors of blue to enlighten the effect of the river. And that's basically it. Once I had the topographical map of the place where I live, I just determined all the areas which I wanted to color using a different depth, and there you go. I am so happy with how this turned out. I'm gonna quickly finish this one, but I'm gonna wrap up the video right here. If you want to see how it looks after I've completely finished it, I've got some sanding to do and stuff like that. Be sure to follow me on Instagram And if you have any questions about this build or about rainbow wood or whatever, just hit me up on Instagram, give me a question there, and I'll be sure to come back to you. But for now, it's a wrap. I'll see you next time, and don't forget to make something colorful. Bye bye.